Ken is here with a colorful way to help keep our entryways free of snow and dirt with a fantastic DIY doormat. Welcome, Ken.
Hello. Yes, doormats. This time of year, there's so much dirt being trekked in, and I'm so tired of just the standard coir, like, or rubber doormat. This
of is course
the
way you are.
To have one that's fabulous, it is inexpensive. You put it outside in front of your house, and the dirt will fall through. Very easy to
make. And people will be talking about
it. And people will be talking about the doormat.
For sure. Okay, like I already mentioned, I love this, so let's get started. What do we do first?
So all you're going to need is 2x2s.
Okay.
2x2s, and get them at the hardware store. Have them cut them. I made mine 18 inches. You can make the doormat as long as you want, but start with your 18 inches.
Very simple cuts that they can do for you.
They can do for that.
Yeah.
I'm going to ask you, Mr. Cameron, what you're going to do is get your drill and about 3 inches in from the tip.
Got it.
With a quarter inch bit, just drill straight down inside of each one. So this is like a great kind of...
it's on reverse.
Have your drill going forward, not on reverse.
It's always sneaky when they surprise you and they have the drill in reverse.
That was probably my fault. And then what you're going to do is, I found the best thing to use is paracord. You can get this at craft stores and fabric stores.
Okay.
What you want to do is cut a piece about 3 times the width of your door.
Got it.
You want to singe the end of it with a little bit of a flame, if you can see that, because it's going to keep it from fraying and make it a lot easier to thread
That's
through.
A really good tip.
I'm going to give one side to you.
Okay.
What you're going to do is thread both sides through.
Okay.
And pull that all the way through, get it relatively evenly. Okay, so one side is going to be like that.
Okay, let's make sure we're about even here.
We're about even.
I guess we can always adjust later.
Adjust later.
Yeah.
And then what you're going to do is, from the craft store, just get your wood beads. Beads that are holes through on both sides.
I mean, pretty simple. Now, why do you want to use these wooden beads?
What it does is it's going to give you the spacing that's needed. Then we're just going to keep on threading bead to 2x2.
Could you use something else other than the wood beads?
Well, you could actually do it and just knot it in between each one, but I find that knotting it is a little bit trickier and a little bit less consistent. Now, what you don't want to do is forget to put a bead between your 2x4.
Who would do that?
2x2.
That would never happen.
There you go. Never happened. And you want to keep that consistent space. A, it's going to make the mat look nice, and that's where all the dirt falls through keeps it from coming into your house.
Now, do you have to treat the wood at all in a special way?
So here's the deal. If you really want this to last forever, make it out of redwood or cedar or something like that.
Nice.
But you really don't need to. It's so inexpensive. This is going to last you 5-6 years. And then if it does start to rot, you can put it in the wood pile and, you know, go on.
Fantastic.
If you do want to make sure it stays pristine looking, a coat of polyurethane on the front. So if you can see here, this one is coming together. This is all natural wood. You would make that as long as you want. So if you have a double door, French door, you don't have to spend $1 million for a custom one.
Or as wide as you want, too, depending on the cuts that
exactly.
you use, right?
And you can then get interesting. I like the natural, but I did the rainbow one. But I also here did the blue one. So you can really make it match anything. And all you're going to do to finish it off, you got your paracord. If I can borrow your finger, sir, right there.
See,
you want to make sure. See, you knew you were going to be useful.
I was going to be useful no matter what.
And you're just going to tie that off. You want to make sure it's nice and tight, and that's going to keep the mat nice and steady.
Right, because you don't want this to start separating and everything.
Exactly.
I need to talk to you about the paint, though. What kind of paint would you recommend?
Okay, so what I did is, we have the Design Master spray paint. Was that translucent spray paint? I've used it before on papers.
Right.
I like that because you can see the grain through it. You could also use a stain, but that's going to be a little bit more work. I think the spray paint is the easiest thing, and I love seeing the grain.
And I also love, I think on both examples that you used, that you kept the beads natural.
Mostly that's because painting a bead is really difficult.
Oh, I thought it was
It also looks
choice.
Nice.
I thought it was a design choice.
It was a design choice. We'll stick with that.
Well, we'll go with it because it's working.